Hello everyone, I am Deepa Mishra of class 11th A. Each year on 1st of December, we commemorate the World AIDS Day. People around the world stand together to show their support for those who are suffering from the HIV and also remember those who died from AIDS-related illnesses. Each year we focus on specific theme for this day, and this year it will be End Inequalities and AIDS and Pandemics. This themes join with the growing list of challenges that the world is facing today, and it is also to alert people globally for the microbial diseases that are spreading in many parts of the world. Founded in 1988, World AIDS Day was the first ever United Nations International Day for Global Health. Each year, UN agencies, governments, NGOs, civil societies join together to campaign around the world with specific HIV-related themes. It is to bring awareness, rising activities around the globe, make people wear the red ribbon to show and support solidarity of the people who are living with HIV. To make the voice heard about the issues of the people living with HIV, to raise funds and to mobilize AIDS response programs. World AIDS Day on 1st of December remains relevant to today's scenario of the COVID pandemic. To remind people and the government that we are living in a world of microbial diseases, they can cause havoc in the population of mankind. It is possible to eradicate such diseases only by increasing awareness among the people about the various modes of spreading of these diseases, and at the same time, it is the end to stigma and discrimination of people towards the patient who are the sufferers. So let us join hands to commemorate this day for the eradication of such diseases from the world, or at least stop them from spreading, and also to show our sympathy and support to all who are involved in such activities to save us all from havoc that stands as a disaster in front of us. Thank you.
Hello everybody, I am Palak Singh of class 11th A. Let me tell you about AIDS as a disease. AIDS stands for Acquired Immunodeficiency Syndrome. It is caused by a retrovirus called HIV or human immune virus. When infected by this virus, a person suffers from deficiency of immune power in his or her body. Therefore, infection by any microbe can be life-threatening for him, as his body has very less abilities to produce the antibodies required to resist the spread of the disease. AIDS had been a killer for many decades now, but the sting of the disease has been curbed for now, as people had been made aware of various ways of spreading. On the happy note, it is good to see that people are taking ultimate care to protect themselves and others. AIDS can be spread through various ways, like unprotected sex with the infected person, sharing needles for intramuscular injections, through unscrutinized blood for transfusion, and from a mother to the child at the time of delivery. The causes of AIDS can be brought down if sufficient safety measures are availed and practiced. With this note, I hope I have conveyed enough message to you all about AIDS, and wish a world free of all these dreadful eventualities. Thank you. Good health to all.